An 81-year-old female presents to the office with swelling underneath her chin and a draining fistula. It turned out this was much more than just a simple infection. The full case today on The Open Reduction. Welcome to The Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today we're going over a case of terrible bony destruction. This patient is an 81-year-old female who recently developed pain, swelling, and drainage in her submental region. She has no history of trauma, and this has never happened to her before. On exam, there is a significant amount of edema in her submental region. There is also a purulent draining fistula. Her floor of mouth is slightly elevated. She's missing most of her teeth, but she still has her anterior mandibular dentition. After the clinical exam, I obtained a cone beam CT. The radiograph clearly demonstrates that her anterior mandible is in terrible condition. There is bony destruction throughout the anterior mandible, and it extends to the inferior border. The cortical bone appears moth-eaten. Thankfully, I don't see any sign of a pathologic fracture, which is a huge concern in a clinical presentation like this. So, based on her clinical exam and her radiographic findings, which of these medications do you think she most likely is on? Is it A, Fosamax, B, Metformin, C, Methotrexate, or D, Prolia? If you said D, then you're correct. This patient is relatively healthy, but she does suffer from osteoporosis. Her physician started her on Prolia injections a couple years ago in an effort to increase her bone density. You may be saying, why not answer A? Fosamax is a bisphosphonate and can cause a similar presentation. But the question was, which medication is she most likely on? Oral bisphosphonates like Fosamax have a much lower risk of causing spontaneous hemorrhage as opposed to an injected medication like Prolia. Check out this video on my channel to learn more about the statistical risks of hemorrhage. I'll also have all this information on my website, theopenreduction.com. So, we have an 81-year-old female with a deep neck infection, a necrotic anterior mandible, and a very high risk of a pathologic fracture. We need to correct this problem before things get drastically worse. I decided to address this case by performing an online virtual surgery and then having a custom reconstruction plate fabricated. Thankfully, her posterior mandible is healthy and solid, so I'm going to use it bilaterally as an anchor. I also decided to extract her remaining mandibular dentition to get a watertight seal over her mandible. This will eliminate the risk of oral contamination of the surgical site and also isolate the bone. This procedure is performed in the hospital under general anesthesia. First, I extracted her mandibular teeth and then closed the site with two layers of sutures to obtain a primary watertight closure. Then I rescrubbed and moved to the neck. I approached the mandible via a submental incision and dissection. I like the submental incision because it's a relatively easy approach. There are no nerves of concern in this dissection, and it's a straight shot to the anterior mandible. Next, I went below the periosteum and exposed the mandible and identified the mental nerve bilaterally. I confirmed the fit of the plate and then drilled the holes. I then removed all the necrotic bone and submitted it for cultures and path. Next, I put the plate in its correct position and secured it with bicortical screws. The mandible is secure, but it's very thin, so I used graft material to create more mandibular bone. In this case, I used BMP, and it worked incredibly well. I monitored this patient in the office for a year after the procedure. Here is her final cone beam CT. I'm thrilled with how everything looks. She has an incredibly robust mandible now, secured by a reconstruction plate. There is no sign of hemorrhage, and she's still able to get her Prolia shots. She has a wide bony platform for a mandibular denture, and she's able to function with it very well. This before and after shows how well this graft worked. I love it. Thanks so much for watching. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and keep an eye on my website, theopenreduction.com. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.